In the last video, we learned about chronic inflammation and three nutrition-related factors that could lead to its manifestation. In this video, we'll zoom in further and take a look at a tool that could assess the inflammatory potential of our diets, as well as the top 5 food components we should include in our diets according to this tool. Hi, I'm Chung, a qualified nutritionist with a master's in nutritional sciences, here to share with you the latest evidence-based findings on healthy eating and living. The tool that we will focus on today is called the Dietary Inflammatory Index, or DII. I'll simply refer to it as the index for the rest of this video. The index was developed by Professor James Herbert and his team, and is a validated tool that could be used to assess whether a diet might lead to more or less inflammation. The index was developed in 2009 and was based on data compiled from 929 studies to evaluate whether specific dietary components are pro or anti-inflammatory as measured by 6 inflammation markers, including c-reactive protein or CRP. Don't worry too much about the specifics of these markers, and just know that they are a few of the most common markers used in studies to measure inflammation. The Dietary Inflammatory Index was then validated by its ability to predict increases in inflammation by following 494 participants over a 1-year period, during which their dietary intake was recorded and their inflammation status as assessed by high-sensitivity C-reactive protein or HSCRP was determined. The results validated that a 10% improvement in the index was associated with a 24% lower risk of having an elevated HSCRP of greater than 3 mg per liter. In 2013, the index was further improved in a few ways. First, 11 national food consumption databases from around the world were used to determine global averages for the consumption of each food component. Second, the number of research studies included to build the index was almost doubled from about 900 to close to 2,000 papers. And third, the index was expanded to include 6 broader classes of flavonoids with a lot of new research supporting their antioxidant and anti-inflammatory properties. Based on these improvements, the dietary index calculated for any one person could range from 7.98, which would indicate a maximally pro-inflammatory diet, to -8.87, which would indicate a maximally anti-inflammatory diet. The food parameters used in calculating the index include more traditional dietary components such as different types of fats, vitamins and minerals, various traditional anti-inflammatory spices such as garlic, ginger and turmeric, as well as anti-inflammatory nutrients with more recent research such as dietary fiber and various flavonoids. So, has the Dietary Inflammatory Index been shown to be associated with an increased risk of various chronic diseases? Before I go into that detail, if you've learned something in this video, do help me by hitting the subscribe and the like buttons and turn on the notifications. You could also check out this other video on the specifics of some foods that could help to reduce chronic inflammation. Even though the researchers have validated that the index is associated with the inflammation marker of HSCRP, how well does the index actually perform in terms of being associated with the risk of developing as well as dying from various chronic diseases? In this meta-analysis, data from 9 prospective studies with about 130,000 participants was analyzed. The results showed that individuals with the most pro-inflammatory index compared to the participants with the most anti-inflammatory index had a 22% higher risk of dying from all causes, including a 24% higher risk of dying from a cardiovascular disease and a 28% higher risk of dying from cancer. The comparison also showed a 32% higher risk of developing CVD for the individuals with the most pro-inflammatory index. Of the 45 food components of the Dietary Inflammatory Index, which are the top 5 components that are the most anti-inflammatory? You could pause the video and drop some guesses in the comments before you continue watching. Number 5 is beta-carotene. Beta-carotene is one of the main sources of vitamin A that we can obtain from plant foods, with the highest amounts found in foods such as carrots, pumpkins, spinach, mustard greens, and sweet potatoes. Vitamin A then plays an important role in maintaining a healthy gut barrier and gut immune system, both of which will help to reduce chronic inflammation in the gut. In fact, The levels of beta-carotene circulating in our blood has been consistently linked in various studies as a biomarker for healthy eating patterns that are associated with positive health outcomes. Number four is isoflavones, a component found in one of my personal favorite, that is soy foods. This meta-analysis of 24 randomized controlled trials showed that soy supplementation could reduce CRP by 0.11 milligrams per liter, or about 4% from baseline. But most interestingly, the meta-analysis also showed that when the analysis was performed on studies that used only natural soy products, such as tofu, soy milk, and soybeans, CRP was even more significantly reduced by 0.23 milligrams per liter, or about 9% from baseline. This effect from natural soy foods is also echoed by other similar studies. Number three is flavones. Flavones are a particular type of antioxidant, primarily consisting of epigenin and luteolin. Some of the foods that contain the highest amounts of flavones include parsley, green bell peppers, celery, black olives, and red grapes. There hasn't been as much research done on flavones as compared to other flavonoids, but the antioxidant and anti-inflammatory effects of epigenin and luteolin have been demonstrated by many cell studies and animal studies. Before I continue on to the top two food components of the index, if you've not already done so, help me hit the like and subscribe buttons and turn on the notifications. And if you found this introduction to the Dietary Inflammatory Index interesting and helpful, I would deeply appreciate it if you could share this video with just one of your friends or family members whom you feel will benefit from watching it. Number two is dietary fiber. Besides isoflavones, fiber is definitely one of my personal champions in terms of helping to reduce inflammation. Fiber contains many different categories, but the main type of fiber that might be helping to reduce inflammation is probably the fermentable fiber that nourishes our gut microbiota. Fermentable fiber is metabolized by our gut microbiota into beneficial short-chain fatty acids that have been shown to have multiple health benefits. In this meta-analysis, higher intake of fermentable fiber compared to lower intake reduced the pro-inflammatory markers of C-reactive protein and TNF-alpha, as well as increased the anti-inflammatory marker of IL-10. And finally, at number one is turmeric. Turmeric has a long history of being used in both Ayurvedic and traditional Chinese medicine, and is used extensively in Indian and Southeast Asian cooking. The active ingredient in turmeric is called curcumin, and many studies have demonstrated their anti-inflammatory effects, among other health benefits. So, what's the takeaway from the top 5 food components of the Dietary Inflammatory Index? We again see a consistent pattern of eating a wide variety of plant foods that are high in beta-carotene, isoflavones, flavones, and dietary fiber to reduce the risk of developing chronic inflammation and chronic diseases. In these other videos, I'll explain what is chronic inflammation, as well as dive deeper into some of the beneficial food components from the Dietary Inflammatory Index, including the global averages and recommended amounts of each component that you could add to your diet. Check them out now, and I'll see you next time.